This is a Citroen e-C4, it's a 2021 Shine Plus model, and in this video I'm just going to talk about the instrument display.
So let's start it up by pushing the button down there turn the radio off. So on these, the dashboard is rather small. You've just got this little screen here, even though the screen itself is larger. Let me just turn the heating off as well. And a lot of videos I've seen on these cars get it wrong as to the information you can have up on the screen. For example, a lot of videos say you can't have the battery state of charge percentage, but you can. And in this video, I'm going to go through all the settings on this screen and show you exactly what you can have up on there, exactly the information that you can have on this small instrument cluster. So this screen is backlit, as you can see there, which doesn't really serve any purpose, but the actual screen itself is much smaller than the whole black area. You can see there's a good 1.5 inches either side, but you can probably just make out which bit is actually the screen, and you can't display much information at the same time. I wish you could, because you have to choose what you want in the middle. You do always retain the estimated range and your battery charge there, and the odometer there, that the amount of miles the car has done, and you retain the speed and your gear there, but this bit in the middle you can change. It's a shame that they couldn't fit more information on the screen, because for example at the moment we're showing the power meter, and that's something I would like to keep on the screen all the time, because it allows you to sort of modulate your accelerator pedal to basically coast and drive without any regen. And that's something I think all electric vehicles should have, a power meter up on the screen all the time. But anyway, I'm going to go through how you change this and look at the various screens you can have here to change that information in the middle. So primarily, to change that information, you use the buttons on the end of the stalk. You've got a button there on the end of the light and indicator stalk, and you've got another button there on the end of the wiper stalk, and both of those change information up on the screen. So firstly, I'm going to use the wiper stalk, and if I press that, I get the trip information, and there you can see your battery percentage. So this is, one press gives you an instant driving efficiency and your battery percentage. A second push gives you your trip A, and a third push gives you your trip B, and a single push again, you're back to your instant driving economy. And then if you just wait a few seconds, that information disappears. So that's how you get the battery state of charge up in percentage terms. It's just a single push, and it tells you there 44%. So using this second button here, if you push that, you've then got various options there that you can scroll through. So you've got personal one, personal two, navigation, driving, and minimum. So I think minimum, yes, that's what I had it on before. So minimum is your power meter. So if I push it again and change to personal one, you can see there the screen changes, and now I've got my heater power use up there. That's something other electric vehicles don't have. It's something unique to Stellantis vehicles, what originally was on the PSA vehicles. So this is something that was in the Peugeot Partner and Citroen Berlingo van, and this is basically telling you how much power your heater is using. So let's try that. So at the moment it's 11 degrees outside, and I've got the heater cooling for 20 degrees, and we can see there we've now got, there we go, that's going up to near maximum. It's showing us, there we are, well, maximum there. It's showing us the power the heater is drawing. But it only gives you it in these sort of blocks, so it doesn't really mean anything. You can't tell how many kilowatts it's drawing. But as you can see, after only 5 seconds, that's dropped right the way down. So there was initial burst of power required to get the air conditioning compressor going and to get the heat pump system all working, but now this is going to probably fluctuate up and down as it starts generating the heat to get it through the air vents. So it's a bit of a useless display really, but it does mean that when the heating is running, you can maybe knock the temperature down a little bit and see it change there, and it's all designed to help you preserve energy. But as you can see, it's pulsating up and down, probably as that air conditioning compressor is kicking on and off to get the heat pump working. So that was personal one. Now for personal two, and in my case I have got the trip meters, which I thought you can also get on that button. So that's the screen I generally have it on most of the time, because I've got that battery percentage which I want to see. And that personal one and personal two you can set up there on the screen, which I'll show you in a minute when we've gone through all these options. So next, let's go to navigation. And then it changes your display there. And then if you're using the inbuilt navigation, you will get the next turn up there on the screen. But if you're not using the navigation, you get a compass, and that's pretty much the same as what other vehicles do. However, if you're using Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, this isn't going to work. It only works if you use the inbuilt navigation. So let's just test that. So I'll go into the navigation, and I'm going to enter an address. And let me just put Birmingham. And let me put, I don't like this navigation, but anyway, put Aston Street, Birmingham, number 3. Okay. And then, as you can see, we've now got an arrow telling us to get onto the route because we're off the road at the moment, but we will then get the turn navigation symbols up there in the dash, and you also get the same up there on the heads-up display. So pushing the button then, the next one is driving, and as you can see there's a bit of a delay every time it changes because it does that sort of graphic animation, which is a bit pointless. But anyway, this is basically giving us the lane keep information. So when you're, the lane keep is working, this goes green. And I think this is also showing us the distance between the car in front that you've got set with the radar. And then the final thing, we're back to minimum, which gives us our parameter. So that's all the screens you can have up there in your instrument cluster. So now I'll show you how you set that personal one and personal two. So you do that up on the main screen, and you need to go to settings, but you've got a shortcut to it there. And then you go to options, and then you go to instrument panel personalization. And this is where you've got number one and number two. So you can see number one I've got set to the heater, number two I've got to set to the trip computer. So this is where you can change what you have on number one and two. So you can select media or energy. So if I select media and then say OK, and then jump back here and change that to personal one, we'll then have a media display, which in this case I've got it on DAB LBC radio. And the other option there was energy, and there we can see we've got our energy display. And if I go to number two, we've got media again, trip computer, and the heater. So the same sort of information. So obviously you can customize what you want to see on that number one and number two option. And that's your lot. That's all the information you can have on the screen. It's just a shame that you can't have a lot of this on the screen at the same time. It would be nice if the battery percentage was here instead of this graph, or they could even get rid of that little battery symbol there and just have a percentage there. But The key thing, the reason why I wanted to make this video is because a lot of the other review videos up there on YouTube, and there are absolutely loads on the EC4, I haven't seen any of them where they've gone through that information you can get up there on the screen. So that will do for this one. Keep it short and sweet. If you found it useful, as always, please do click the thumbs up button. That really does help. Do subscribe to the channel and have a look at the playlist in the video description below, where you can see other videos on the Citroen EC4 electric. Not too many at the moment, but there will be others coming out over the next few weeks. And I'll see you on the next video.